Throughout his poems, he always exhorted the need to carry forward resistance against all forms of oppressions. This poem also conveys the very same ideas. Now coming to the questions that can be asked from this extended poetic piece. Of course, comprehension testing questions from the given stanza, as we had from the in-depth reading poem. Questions to find out the poetic craft, such as rhyming words, rhyme scheme, images and figures of speech. Of course, such questions can be asked. These are the two types of questions that are generally asked. Now we come to the last part of the unit, but by no means the least in importance. Hope you know that it is a language element part. Is it a tough bit for you to crack? I hope it is not. But the general consensus is that the language element part is a bit difficult for the students. Actually, we can find questions from language element, of course, in the evaluation tool in certain areas. In fact, areas in what I mean is we can find these kind of questions. Language element is tested when a paragraph is edited, then fill up with correct prepositions, articles, etc. So these are the various stages where language element testing is incorporated. Reporting conversations, then change the voices, completing statements with appropriate tag questions, I should say framing questions, and other structural items. So these are the areas where language element proficiency is being tested. Now coming to of course our unit, the first unit consists of a sea of language elements. I should say it has got language elements in such as abundance that, of course, such an abundance cannot be detected in any other unit. The first one is all about imperatives. In fact, of course, we knowingly or unknowingly hear a lot of imperatives and render a lot of imperatives, but of course my personal opinion is that it is for the very first time that the students have detected imperatives. Of course, they are saying imperatives at home, they are hearing imperatives at home, they are saying and hearing imperatives at school as well. Of course, throughout their existence in the society, they are actually of course making it, but it's for the very first time that they actually found it out. Of course, at home we generally of course hear imperatives like this: of course, get up, brush your teeth, take baths, eat the breakfast, go to school on time. Of course, all these are imperatives we generally see at homes. In fact, now we come to imperatives at schools. Of course, at school, of course, come in, as the teacher may be suggesting you to come in. Now of course, stand up, take numbers, keep quiet, turn to page 30, don't shout, of course, close your books. So all these are imperatives that we generally hear. In fact, so there can be questions as to of course in the evaluation tool as to find out imperatives. Of course, now the second activity in that particular unit one is about past perfect. You know, past perfect is a very important tense form. It is the past in the past. Of course, it is referred as the past in the past, and how and where it is used, it's a matter of certain concern for the students. In fact, let me of course bring before you one example regarding this. I reached the railway station at 9 a.m. the train came at 9:30 a.m. so the first action was I reaching the railway station. So past perfect has to be used with that. In fact, before the train came, I had reached the railway station. Before the train came, I had reached the railway station. Let me exemplify with one more example. The patient died. Only after that, the doctor arrived. The doctor arrived only after the patient had died. So this past perfect, of course, a testing can be done in the examination, And I think it will come in, of course, in the editing session or in correction session. Of course, I mean, correction is editing, in fact, or in the sentence completion session. So these are the two places where these past perfect questions can be expected. The next one is about reported speech or reporting conversations, in fact. The third, of course, activity is reporting conversation. It's an activity to report different types of statements. Different types of statements, I mean assertive statements, of course, imperative statements, exclamatory statements, and interrogative statements. So different types of statements are presented, and it's an exercise. Of course, the third activity in the language element part is an, of course, exercise to make the student proficient in different type of sentence reportings, in fact. See, I'm not shouting, Swami said, it's an assertive sentence which is to be reported. Swami said that he was not shouting. Swami, where is your homework? The teacher asked. It's an interrogative sentence, in fact. And the reporting may be like this. The teacher asked Swami where his homework was. Now, is it true that father asked? It's an SO not question reporting, where you have to, of course, use if or whether after the reporting verb. The father wanted to know if it was true. Or the father asked if it was true. The father inquired if it was true, in any way you like. Get up from bed, Swami, the mother said. It's an imperative sentence. The mother asked Swami to get up from bed. So these are different type of sentences, and activity 3 is all about reporting different type of course, sentences also. Now, another thing that we have to bear in mind is fixing the exact reporting verb for reporting, in fact. So in order to fix the exact reporting verb, you will have to get familiarized with, or you will have to realize the tone of the speech.